Thank you very much. Hello, you San Francisters. I hope you were not at all inconvenienced by the index finger detectors on the way in. Now, as you know, a scientist from right here in San Francisco, a guy named Dr. Breedlove, studied three street fairs in San Francisco. There's a wide open set right there. And he found that if your index finger on your right hand is shorter than your ring finger, which is problematic given that gay people cannot marry, if your index finger is shorter than your ring finger, then he said, chances are you are gay. And he published his findings in a magazine called Nature. They're all checking out their hands right now. Don't be afraid. Oh my God, I'm a bisexual. Charge them double. And I wouldn't dream of speaking for gay men who have no problem speaking for me. I think that with the shortened index finger on the right hand, it goes a long way to explain why gay men are such terrible bowlers. And yet, with that index finger out of the way, they make excellent snappers. So he said that if your index finger is shorter than your ring finger, chances are you are gay. Or you could be a shop teacher. But oddly enough, a scientist from South Carolina, just one, he did the same study, and his name was Dr. Breed Haight. What are the chances? He published his findings in a magazine called Nurture. And he said that the reason that the index finger is shorter on lesbians, and I'm quoting here, it's because they're working them to a nub. And we know, gals, it's not the one, it's the combo. Okay. I love that science news. I read the New York Times every Tuesday for science news. I just love it. And then I try the experiments. I tried the sheep cloning. A mess, all right? And you know, they always leave out some key ingredient in every recipe, don't they? So I took some DNA from a sheep. The guys know. Combined it with DNA from another sheep, I got nothing. I was ready with woolite. And then I tried the cold fusion experiment. Now this is a nuclear experiment. Nuclear is a word George Bush can't say. Well, let's make him president. Because it sounded like all you did was take some ordinary tap water, some things you find around the house, maybe some tubing, and I tried it. And I got nothing. I have vats of sun tea. That's all. Incredible science news. It's all here. You know, I read too that scientists recently discovered that the 25-year drop in fertility among men is caused by disposable diapers. Why 25-year-old men are wearing diapers is a problem. But they said that the diapers get so hot, they kill off sperm. And that is the cause of the infertility. Now, do you see where I'm going with this idea? I'm thinking this is a contraceptive diaper that will make all other contraceptives unnecessary, which I think is a great idea. I mean, are you 486? Yes, I am. Was finally approved by the FDA after 12 years. Yes. It took 12 years. How long did it take them to approve Viagra? That was like 10, 20 minutes, wasn't it? Well, does Bob like it? Oh, sure, let the dance begin. Bob Dole took the Viagra and his arm went up. Yeah, that was mean. But I've been busy. I'll tell you, when I'm not here at the Herbst Theater and Entertainment Complex, I have been busy searching to map the human genome. Because I'm worried. Guys don't ever read maps. They don't know how to fold them. And they haven't gotten so many things right. I mean, they lost the Mars probe. That was the saddest picture, I thought, in the paper. Those guys waiting for the call from the Mars probe. They're like... Scientists mixed up feet and meters. So apparently it is rocket science. Computer scientists did not take into account that there would ever be anything called the year 2000. I'm worried. They're still testing the Star Wars missile defense system. Nothing has gone right. They shot off the missile, it didn't go off. The dummy missile, again, not George Bush, did not work. You know, I think if we're going to have a Star Wars missile defense, we should use Kenstar. Put him up on the top of a hill, he'll swat things away. And you saw that the Whitewater investigation yielded nothing for $55 million. And the cost to the American psyche, priceless. So I'm worried. They haven't got anything right. I think the only thing worse than a right-wing think tank is a right-wing human genome project. So when I'm not with you, I am working 24/7, splicing and dicing the DNA, and I will find the lesbian gene. And then I'm going to replicate that sucker. And I do have to apologize for one thing. I apologize to you for wearing clothes during the show tonight. Now, as you know, usually I don't wear clothing during the show. It is really the source of a lot of humor. And but I'm wearing clothing tonight in solidarity with my nude dancing sisters, who were recently mandated, you probably saw this, by the Supreme Court, which is now online. Whew. I feel the excitement in the room. I'm wet. But don't worry, I have my missile shield on. But the Supreme Court recently said that nude dancers must now wear clothing. I'm as mystified as you about that. The Supreme Court's been busy, though, very busy. They recently ruled that partial birth abortions are all right if you read the Miranda rights to the woman first. I could have gotten that wrong, but I'm not an actual lawyer. And the Supreme Court also ruled that public money can be sent to private schools if you jam it in boxes labeled computer. But I know the one you're all interested in, and that was the Supreme Court ruling on gay scouting. The Supreme Court ruled that there can be no gay scouts. They took the out of scout. So now it's the Boy Skins of America. We can dearly hope they don't merge with the 4-H. I know there's a Joe Lieberman joke there somewhere, but no. No, the Supreme Court said that now nude dancers must wear pasties and G-strings when they perform. And that is why I'm wearing clothes in solidarity with my nude dancing sisters. The Supreme Court said that nude dancing causes negative secondary effects in a community. And I know you're wondering, gosh, what are those negative secondary effects? And you know, I happen to know. They said those negative secondary effects are prostitution, sexual assault, and my own personal favorite, tax evasion. Well, following that crime-fighting logic, I recommended to the police department of New York City, where I'm now living, I said, if you want to fight crime, get the policemen out of those blue uniforms, get them in pasties and G-strings, and make every police headquarters into an H&R Block. It was a great idea, but the mayor of New York did not go for it. The mayor of New York, Adolph Giuliani. He's out of control. He rounded up homeless people at Christmas time and put them in jail. A black man was shot 41 times reaching for his wallet in a kind of fundraising thing gone bad, apparently. And the mayor was upset about objectionable art at the Brooklyn Museum. Now, can you imagine a Republican upset about elephant dung? And you know, it turns out that the mayor is a major babe magnet. Chicks love him. I know, when I look at him, I think, ooh, hold me back. Is that a comb over? But the mayor's wife, soon to be ex-wife, announced recently that she is going to appear in an off-Broadway show called The Vagina Monologues. I thought, she must hate his guts. But it's amazing. You walk around the street in New York and you see the marquee. There it is, The Vagina Monologues. It's very impressive. It's so impressive, I decided to call my new CD, My Vagina Prefers Dialogue. Talk to me. But the mayor's had his problems. He announced that he had prostate cancer. I had nothing to do with it. Okay, I did have a little doll. Poke, poke, poke. It was weird, though. He announced he had prostate cancer, and then the police commissioner announced that he had prostate cancer a couple of days later. It was like a Spartacus moment. I have prostate cancer. No, I have prostate cancer. I have, like, sit down, miss. You couldn't possibly have prostate cancer. But they're treating him now. He's being treated for his prostate cancer, and apparently they've put radioactive pellets into his prostate, and now he's x-raying luggage at JFK.